Hello friends, today we will discuss non-conventional energy source, biomass energy. I am Dr. S.B. Kolle, Department of Physics, Shivaji Arts, Commerce and Science College, Kannad, District Aurangabad. So friends, what is biomass? It is renewable organic material that comes from plants and animals. The biomass which includes phytomass, means plant biomass, and zoo biomass is animal biomass. Means plant biomass is called phytomass and animal biomass is called zoo mass. Means biomass is combination of plant biomass and animal biomass. Means waste material from plants and waste material from animals, both are in this biomass. So what is biomass energy? Energy obtained from biomass is known as biomass energy. See here in this diagram, garbage, crops, wood, landfill gas, alcohol fuels, these are types of biomass. So what are the sources of biomass? Biomass may be used as energy by burning it or deriving fuel from it. Means either we can burn it directly to get energy, or we can extract fuel from it for energy. Now sources of biomass are as follows. First source is forest. So friends, from long ago, from ancient time, man has been using food, wood as source of fuel. But nowadays we do not use much wood. Also charcoal, producer gas are the sources. This wood is not only used to get heat, but it is also used in sawn timber, paper making industry and other industrial purposes. Second source of biomass is agriculture residue. Crop residue such as straw, rice husk, coconut shell, groundnut shell, sugarcane bagasse. This material is collected and it is gasified to get producer gas. Third source is energy crops. So friends, some cultivated plants produce raw material for biofuels. You know, sugarcane, sweet sorghum, sugar beet. These plants supply raw material for ethanol production. Like Jerusalem artichoke, cassava, potato, sweet potato, maize, rice. These are also used in production of ethanol. Now next source is aquatic plants. Water, hyacinth, kelp, seaweed, algae provide raw material for ethanol. We can get ethanol from these aquatic plants. Now next source is urban waste. You know, energy means man produces a lot of waste material in our daily life. So in municipal corporation collects this solid waste. So energy from this municipal solid waste can be obtained from direct combustion. Also friends, you know, sewage waste is used in production of biogas also. Now biomass conversion technologies. There are many different ways of extracting energy from biomass. First method is physical method. Now in this physical method, pelletization is used. Waste wood is pulverized, dried and forced under pressure through an extrusion device. In this case, we get small pellets of wood. These are used as an energy source. Next is briquetting. Biomass briquettes are made from woody matter as replacement for fossil fuels. Third is expelling agro products. concentrated vegetable oils may be used as fuel in diesel engines. Now next is fuel extraction. Now exudates is obtained by cutting stems or trunks of living plants to get petroleum substitute. In many cases, direct plants are crushed to get this petroleum substitute. Next method is incineration, means direct combustion. Direct combustion of biomass is used for heat purpose. Next is thermochemical method. This method is used to convert this biomass into more convenient or valuable product. Next is biochemical method. Metabolic action of microbial organism on biomass produces liquid and gaseous fuel. Now this can be done by ethanol fermentation or anaerobic fermentation. So what is ethanol fermentation? Decomposition of simple hexose sugar to produce ethanol and CO2 gas. And what is anaerobic fermentation? It converts wet biomass and animal waste into biogas through decomposition process by action of anaerobic bacteria. So what are the advantages of biomass energy? First, it is renewable source. It is very abundant. It does not last. It is renewable. Inbuilt energy source means biomass contain energy derived from sun. Plants capture sun's energy and convert this energy into carbohydrates. They capture carbon dioxide and convert it into oxygen. So it is inbuilt energy source. It requires little or no foreign exchange. Economic development. By this biomass plants, we can do economic development of our area. Less pollutant emission. It is less polluted. No pollution is there, or less pollution is there. Waste disposal management. It is very important problem. How to dispose waste material? In daily life, in everyday, there is a lot of waste. How to dispose it? It is very great problem. So waste disposal management can be done using this biomass. Next is increases fertility of the land. You know, it increases fertility of the land. We can use it as fertilizer. No seasonality. In every season, we can use this biomass energy. Now, what are disadvantages of biomass energy? Disperse and land intensive source. It is dispersed source, land intensive. Means it requires less land. And it disperses natural source. Low energy density. But main disadvantage is it is low energy density source. We get low energy from this. Other than these biofuels, other than these coals, like other sources of energy. Labor land intensive source, it also requires small labor, less amount of, means less human resource. Capacity depends on availability. It is also very clear that the capacity of this energy, it depends on availability of that biomass. Not feasible to set up at all locations. References are used for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.